Okay, good morning, class.
Good morning, ma'am.
Okay. So everybody, can you stand up? Mary, please. Mr. Aki, go lead the prayer. Okay. Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Okay. So before sitting down, can we pick up pieces of paper under your chairs? Arrange yourself. Okay. Can we sit down? Okay. So where is Miss Karen?
She's absent, ma'am.
Karen is absent today. Who else is absent?
No one, ma'am.
Okay, no one.
Karen.
So, before we start our lesson class, I want you to recall the topic that we discussed yesterday. So, yesterday we discussed about... Okay, very good. We discussed about the different factors involved in... DNA sequence, okay? So, yesterday we've learned about, okay, very good. So, this morning, I want you to look at this picture. So, Mr. Ate.
Tomato, ma'am.
Okay, this is a tomato. So, Miss Buzz.
Yes.
Can you compare the tomato from the left side and the right side?
The tomatoes in the right.
It's rotten.
No, it's already ripe.
Right? What else?
But those in the left.
The right one is complete.
Complete?
Right. Complete. The color is very good.
Okay.
And the left side.
Very good. Okay, next. This is
a corn.
Okay, this is the Zeta maize, or also known as a native corn. Okay, so what did you see in the picture, class?
The upper side is good in terms of the picture, the color, and the lower side is not good because I think there is.
Okay, very good, Mr. Atis. Mr. Atis is very brilliant today. Okay, what about this one? What did you notice on the...
The shape of the melon,
okay.
Ma'am. Different.
Have you tried giving this one, class?
The yes, shape, yes. One is the right. The one on the right.
This one. What about this one?
The shape is different.
Not yet, ma'am.
Okay, did you see this one in actual class?
No, ma'am.
In the settings?
Different.
No, ma'am.
Okay, what about this one?
Oh, amazing.
Amazing.
The right side is color red and the left side is color yellow.
What about this one?
The right side there is a seed, there are seeds, but the left side there is no seeds.
Okay, very good. Next.
The upper side is very good in terms of the shape and complete in terms of and the lower side.
Okay, very good, Mr. Atis. Okay, next.
I think that
those are papayas, ma'am.
Okay, those are prega papaya.
The right side is cultured.
Papayas.
Cultured, and the other side is not cultured.
Okay, so
small size.
Okay, so what about this one?
Oh, banini.
Okay, this is banana. Okay, masa sa piento. So this one on the right side is
very good.
Very smooth.
Smooth, but the other side is
very
okay. It has necrotic spots and the but and it's okay.
Oh my god,
skin. Okay, what about this one? Have you ever seen this one, class?
Yes, it's menopausal.
No, no, I haven't seen.
I did see it.
I was a poultry boy.
Poultry boy. So this one actually, class, is a naked chicken. Do you know that this one exists in other countries?
Yeah.
Oh.
No.
So why do you think those organisms exist, class?
It's because of the technology nowadays.
Okay, very good. Because of the technology that we are currently using now. So our topic this morning is about genetic engineering. Okay. So what do you see in the picture, Jimril?
I think it's DNA.
Okay, these are actually the DNA. And this one, what did the girl do?
She tries to cut
this is the base or the sequence of the DNA. So this morning, this will be our objective class. So number one, we will define what is genetic engineering. Okay, second, we will apply the process involved in the genetic engineering. And last, we will discuss the possible benefits and risks of the GM products, or also known as genetically modified products or genetically modified organism. Okay, so what is a GMO, Mr. Atis?
GMO bomb is a genetically modified organism.
Okay, it can be an animal, a plant, or a microbe whose DNA has been altered. So the DNA is being altered. So if we have sequence of DNA, some part of the sequence are being cut. Okay, it's being altered to produce desired organism. Okay, so these are common in, for example, the one that I have displayed a while ago, in the corn, in the cattle, and even in dogs. Okay, so Ms. Bas, can you read?
Genetic engineering is sometimes called genetic modification.
Okay, with a modification, it means when we modify organism,
we change.
Oh, we change. Okay, it's the process of altering the DNA in an organism genome. So just like what you have said, in the naked chicken, so part of its DNA are being altered. The one that produces skin on its body, and it's being replaced with non-hairy. Okay, something that's being inserted on it to produce such desired products. Okay. So we know, class, we've been discussing this one, that in our DNA we have this one. Now we have our bases. So we all know that adenine should always be paired with, I mean, the C should always be, or the cytosine should always be paired with guanine. So deleting a hole of DNA or introducing an additional copy of a gene can make produce a new organism. Okay? So if you alter some of it, it will produce new products. Okay. So do you know that extracting DNA genome and combining it to the other? So it's being modified by the scientist. So persons who are doing this one are called genetic engineer. And these are very highly paid job. No? They are altering, they work in a laboratory, they are altering genes and produces products. Like for example, we have now the BT corn. There are something genes inserted on it so that when the corn borers will eat on the in the zia maize or in the corn, the corn borer or those worm that eats the corn will eventually die because there are genes already inserted on the corn. Okay, so what are the processes involved, class? So there are a small piece of circular DNA called plasmid, and these plasmid are common in the bacteria. So a small section is then cut up on a circular plasmid by restriction enzymes on a molecular sensors. So I will just go through how it's being done. Okay, so for example, in a plasmid, you have here plasmid in the bacteria. So that plasmid will be taken up in the bacterial cells. And then we have there the restriction enzymes that cuts DNA sequence. And that DNA sequence will be then inserted with the human, this is an example, human insulin genes. And then eventually it will be inserted back to the bacteria so that it will be produced, or it will produce a lot of insulin protein that actually treats diabetic. Okay, so they undergo fermentation and then they purify, and then these are ready for human insulin. Okay, so to treat diabetic. So have you ever asked us what are the possible ways of using the GMO or genetically modified organism, because these are product of genetic engineering? So there are other countries that are against it, stop GMO, because along the way we are not sure of the possible effects of the GMO, or we are not too sure. So we know that today, class, we have a lot of diseases and we are not aware what could be the possible cause of it. It could be the products that we are currently eating. What do you think, Mr. Apis?
I think it's all about the technology that that human created that one, and it is really, it is neglected by the human, and there is no equal attention.
Okay.
So just abnormalities.
So this morning class, I want you to group into two. Okay. So you can go with your groups, and I want you to we will have a debate on, are you in favor of GMOs or are you against it? Okay? So I will give you 10 minutes to prepare, to research and read about GMOs and... Okay, are you done?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, very good. So, Junriel, what did you learn from our lesson today?
I learned that...
What did you learn from the other group about the advantage? Why are you not in favor? Why do you stand that you're not in favor of the GMOs?
I will not in favor of GMOs for the reason that I am the absolute way that people will maintain that one. And for the sake of our health and for the sake of everything.
Okay, Ms. Bass, why did you stand for the... Your group stands for the, you are in favor with the GMO products.
Yes, ma'am, because it's good and it can produce, just like what you said, insulin or for diabetic people.
Okay, very good. So as a summary, Mr. Atis, what did you learn from this, from our lesson?
I learned a lot, ma'am, in terms of the GMO. GMO is very important nowadays because as what the years comes, there is what we call changes, it should be modified. And science is very important because it modifies on how we are going to create a new product.
Okay, very good. Okay, for your assignment, class, I want you to, everybody, can you read?
How do you feel about GM foods? Are they beneficial or harmful? Compare and contrast articles with choice on the following websites. After reading articles from both websites, use your favorite internet search engine to find more information on the GM food debate. Write a short report on your views about GM.
Okay, so I guess that will be all for today. Everybody can stand up. Goodbye and thank you, class.
Goodbye.